Happy Friday, guys, and welcome to the real world. Today, we'll be taking a look at Mission Impossible to see if it's worth watching for your movie watching night. It's time for a real recommendation. Some spoilers ahead. Mission Impossible was Tom Cruise's first role as a big action hero. It was the first time anybody ever saw him as such, and there was some doubt at first. But with his production company backing him, Tom Cruise made this into a blockbuster hit. It was an instant classic, and of course, it made him the superstar we know today. Right from the very beginning, the movie throws us straight into the action. The very first sequence is that of an undercover IMF op, where we're introduced to one of the trademarks of the series, the face mask. And of course, after hearing that signature Mission Impossible theme music, we're thrown into yet another mission. But this time, the stakes are higher. We're treated to some new cool gadgets, at least for the 90s, and some pretty good cinematography. But, one by one, each and every single member of the team we were introduced to is killed off. The mission goes horribly wrong, and only Ethan is the survivor. It really brings you into the drama and suspense. Even if you know what's coming, you're still on the edge of your seat. And that's one of the highlights of the film. When Ethan finds out that he's being framed for the murder of his team, you can feel the dread that you can see very clearly on his face, which is good acting on Tom Cruise's part. But the distorted angles and extreme close-ups really makes it more suspenseful, more intense. And the fish tank explosion that he uses to escape with the bubblegum bomb just looks pretty cool. Throughout the film, though, we're treated to some visually stunning shots and great cinematic moments, and set design, courtesy of director Brian De Palma. Even during parts where there's a lot of explaining, such as during the mission briefings, it flows beautifully, and we actually get to see how high the stakes are and see how the mission could play out, good or bad, which is great storytelling. The pacing and the momentum are in a constant flow, and even during the seemingly slow parts, something always happens. Easily one of the best parts of the entire movie is the heist of the CIA knock list at Langley headquarters. The entire scene is almost in complete silence, and for good reason, as even the slightest sound or movement can completely throw the mission off in disarray. It's incredibly intense, and the tight angles and shots make it even better. It really gives the movie its name, with the mission being completely impossible. But of course, it's Tom Cruise. You know he pulls it off. Still doesn't make it any less awesome. One cool aspect of the movie is the reveal of Jim Phelps, Ethan's former leader and mentor, to be the true villain of the story. It's mainly interesting because Jim Phelps was the protagonist of the original TV series, the series that the movie's based on. It really adds a nice touch connecting the two time periods and makes his betrayal all the more tragic. One of the bigger weaknesses of this film is that it throws a lot of plot at you at once and can sometimes be a little bit confusing and hard to understand. It doesn't help that they throw a lot of spy lingo and other mumbo-jumbo at you, so it can be difficult to pick up on. It really requires you to pay attention, but if you do and you focus on the little details, you'll follow along just fine.
Hasta lasagna, don't get any on you.
And of course, still being a 90s movie, some things haven't aged as well. Namely, the computers inside of the movie, and of course the CGI at the ending train scene. Sometimes it can pull you out a little bit and doesn't seem that realistic, but of course, so many other good things are going for this that it's not that big of a deal. Overall, the first Mission Impossible is an excellently crafted spy thriller that even after over 20 years is still a great movie. It's suspenseful, well-filmed, and just fun to watch. It has to be, to have created a franchise that still exists today. Some parts haven't aged as well, but it's one of those movies you just have to watch at least once in your life. But if Tom Cruise's performance as Ethan Hunt comes up a little bit too short for you, or if it gets you hooked for more spy action, then I'd try your hand at watching Harrison Ford, a CIA agent, Jack Ryan, in Clear and Present Danger. It's available on Netflix as of today. That wraps up this week's Real Recommendation. Thanks for watching. For all those times when you can't go to theaters or don't like what's playing, but just can't decide what to watch at home, be sure to keep it on the real world. Like and subscribe for more videos every Friday, and follow us on social media for updates. Links in the description below. And tell us in the comments what you're going to be watching this weekend. This has been John, and whatever you end up watching, I wish you all a real good weekend.